Hello, Year 9. I've got another video for you as requested by many of you, and it's on this map here, the Birmingham ethnic minority distribution of population map. And I think one that people have been struggling with a little bit in terms of how do I answer a question that asks me to describe distribution of something on a map. So basically, we're thinking about splitting up this map from kind of, north, east, west, south, central, and this kind of southwest cordon, because the map is a little bit strange and it's not a perfect kind of square or circle, or it has this little kind of panhandle, which is a bit of a location that sticks out, as well as these kind of unusual shapes. So how do we answer this question, which I've got in front of me here, which is describe the distribution of ethnic minorities that you in an advanced country that you've studied. Okay, and I'm kind of going to be flicking back and forward between this map, so apologies for all of the kind of interruption, and I'll hopefully get this done in 10 minutes or less. Okay, so what structure are we going to be using? We're certainly going to be using the general comment and specific example structure, so I'm going to put that here, GCSE. And again, that stands for general comment and specific example. So I'm just going to break that up here. Red is going to be my general comment, and blue is going to be my specific example. We're going to bug our question, describe. We are not required to explain anything in this question, which is, good, because we don't need to dip into our knowledge bank of Birmingham. We have everything we need in front of us on that map. The distribution is what we're going to underline while we use our bug strategy. For boxing the command word, U for underline your keywords, and then G, glance back over at the question to see if you're using those keywords. Ethnic minorities is incredibly important here. We're going to be using that word in pretty much every sentence, or referring to a preposition or a word that suggests that that word, a pronoun I should say. And advanced country that we've studied is Birmingham. Okay, and this question could come up as 3 or 4 marks, and it'll just depend on the kind of the amount that you're expected to write, as well as having a comms mark, which is basically trying to get the clear and logical ordering of your answer, okay, by using GCSE in the right order. So I'm just gonna put that there. We did this on Friday in one of my classes, and I'm 100% sure that I've said it 1,000 times to my other class. So we want to make sure that we get that access to that one mark. We're going to get our marks for our GCSE as well. We're also going to get marks for mentioning the distribution, referring to data in terms of describing that distribution. Okay, now move this back over here. I'm going to have a look at the map again very quickly. So, I did say we're going to look at and use directions, north, east, south, west, and any other directions that will be necessary. Okay, and let's just start with our key. Percentage of population from ethnic minorities. We've got 5 different percentages here. Okay, I don't expect you to go and talk about each and every one of them. It would be nice to get a general balance and trying to name as many different locations on the map. So a very obvious one is our central location here, which is actually not the 60% above, it's the 40 to 60%, the kind of the slightly lighter red here. Okay, so we're definitely going to refer to that. We're going to refer to our yellows on the outskirts, because we know that word outskirts. It's going to be a good distribution word in terms of being scattered around the outskirts, below 10%, and we can choose an in-between, so we can go, we can even add some of them together, and we can say, scattered around the central area, or clustered around the central area, whichever you go for. You've got 10% to 20% of ethnic minorities in those locations. Okay, that means that in each of these parts, they are filled with between 10 to 20% of people from ethnic minorities. In the red area here, it's filled with, in depending on where you are in the red area, between 40 to 60% of ethnic people being from ethnic minorities. So what that means is, if you went out to the, you went out on the street, 70 years ago, you would be every person you would be expecting to see would be white British, and now, nearly every second person, depending on where you are, or more than every second person, is going to be from a different culture. Okay, they could be British from another background, or they could be completely not British whatsoever from another background, and that's the way we want to. That's what we need to know about ethnic minorities to have an understanding to answer this question. So, back to our answer. How are we going to structure this? Like I said, red for GC. So I'm going to write in red for my general comments. And I'm going to start with that 40 to 60% and above, 40 to 60% population of ethnic minorities. And we knew that they were in the center of Birmingham, specifically the city center. Okay? So the ethnic population of the city centre of Birmingham is around, and we're going to say 40 to 60%. Based on the map that we have in front of us, based on figure F, if you were to have that as the name of your figure in your exam, but based on figure, which refers to the piece of evidence that you have, and then you just give the name of the figure or the label for that figure. In this case, figure F, but I'm not going to write it. Okay, so that's the first thing. We've referred to a general location, the city center, and then we've given data, which is our 40 to 60%. So I'm just going to fill that in blue, actually, because we know that that's our specific data based on figure F. Slightly weird one, because the city centre, it's the only area coloured in red, the only area with that percentage of people living in it from an ethnic minority. So we're not going to have two separate sentences. But we'll do two separate sentences now for the below 10%. And we saw that they were in the north, they were in the east, and they were in the southwest. Those are general locations. So I'm going to start off with my general comment. And I'm going to say, in the north, we could kind of say northeast, actually, northeast of Birmingham, northeast, we're going to say the east, generally, and we're going to say the southwest. Apologies for the capitals, because they should not be capitals. We're going to basically say here that the population is quite low. Populations of ethnic minorities are low. And I want you to go to page, check the page number for you here, which is page 157. And you're going to go to page 157. And you're going to give me your specific data that you need for this, for the blue part. So you would say something like, specifically, or for example, parts of the northeast have, and then you give me my data that you've got in the key. What percentage of those areas, in terms of population, are ethnic minorities? Tell me that. And we'll do one more. Actually, we're not going to do one more because I'm running out of time, but I would like you to go and do one more, and very quickly, the structure of that will again be general comment, and you can mention the dark red, which is 60% and above, which is scattered around the center, which is a nice distribution word. Okay, so your 60% and above in blue, because it's data, Where are they generally? Okay. Where are they generally? And then this comes down here, doesn't it? And you say that 60% of these areas or more are people from ethnic minorities in Birmingham. So generally we want our compass directions. You could also refer to its location in relation to the city. So you could say one of them is to the west of the city centre. Okay, now that is plenty of information for you to answer that question. And I wish you the best of luck with it. Please make sure you stick to the general comment specific example structure. Again, data goes after your general place, which would be the city centre or Birmingham East, South East, North East. Okay, and you make sure that you get your communications mark, your logical ordering and clear and logical ordering mark. Okay, good luck with that. Year 9.